Hey, it's John from Enduring Charm. In this video, I'm going to cover a new tool that I got. Now, this was sent to me by the General Tool Company, and it's a video inspection system. It's basically a little camera. And this is something I've been interested in reviewing for some time. Now, I'm going to open this box up, but I want to talk about some expectations before we get too far into this. But let's open this box up and see what we got. All right, I opened up the box here, and you know, it's roomy. You got the little manual here. Extra cables for connecting to outside video, I presume. I'll look at that in a minute. And you have the video inspection unit itself. It's fairly good size. I mean, see the size of my hand in comparison. It's kind of an awkward thing to package because you have this long lead here for the video camera. But, you know, seems all right. Now, I want to talk to you about expectations a little bit. You look at some of the specs here. You know, it's a 640 by 480 pixel camera resolution, which is not high in today's world. Does take four AA batteries, and there's LED source of light at the end of the probe there. But what I want to talk about is the expectations. That, you know, this is not an expensive camera. So, you know, if you are looking at this to start doing your own colonoscopies, you know, you're probably gonna have to look elsewhere. It's not a super high resolution camera, and it's not meant for that. And the other thing I want to mention is that, you know, the focus of all of these cameras, not just this one but all of them, is limited by physics, really. So if you're thinking you're gonna stick this through a hole and see an entire room, you're probably mistaken. It's meant for close-up inspection. So you're going to stick this probe into small spaces and be able to see up close what's going on. You're not going to see an entire view like you might see with other types of cameras. So there are physical limitations here we have to understand. So let me get some batteries in this thing and we'll start it up and see what we could do. I am going to try to make up some tests to give an idea of what you can see and what you can't see with these things. All right, let's take a look at the controls now that we have some power. This is the on-off button here, so you hold that down for a second and it'll boot up. And the other controls, actually I have the camera right now pointed at the manual. Probably can't see that on camera, but one important button is this one, which reorients, you know, 180 degrees, I should say, the screen. So if it looks upside down, you just hit this button and that'll be upside right side up. You have two buttons here for the, there's a LED light at the end of the probe. So you can see the light there. And if I turn this, hold it down for a second, the light comes on. All right, and if I could change the brightness, so up or down. If I just hold this down, it goes all the way down. And then this right here, is this button, I'm too close for focus, there we go. This button right here is for zooming in. And again, you just keep pushing the button and it gets all the way to the end of its zoom and then zooms back out. So very easy to control, no problems there. And then the probe is detachable. And I should note that there are other probes available. You know, it comes with this one, which is, you know, kind of a general use, I guess. But there are other types available, and in the manual it does show you. So here are all the other probes available, which you could attach to this if you wanted to. The other things included in this, so you have this video out, so if you had like a TV or something like that, it's an RCA connector. So I, you know, how useful that is in the field, I don't know, but you know, you could do that. And then it has these tips, which are interesting. One is a mirror on there, one, and the other two are able to pick up things at the end. So you could attach these connectors to the end of the probe, and then if you had a, you know, lost screw or something like that, you could use the probe to pick it up. So that could be very useful, in fact. All right, for the first test, what I'm going to do is I have a pipe here, just a metal pipe. It's 1.5 inches inside diameter, and I have here a 5/8 inch wood screw. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the tape measure here to push that wood screw into the pipe, and I'll push it in, you know, about a foot or so, and then I'll use the probe. Maybe I'll go a little more than a foot, actually. I'll go a foot and a half, and then I'll use the probe to stick in that pipe and see if I can recognize that screw or how easily I can recognize that screw. So I'm going to set that up. Now it's a little tough. I'm going to try to film this, but when I'm filming the screen, you know, I'm not sure how much is really going to come through on video. So you're going to have to rely on my description a little bit, but I'm going to give it a shot here and see what we can do. All right. So what I have here, I have the probe inserted into the pipe, and I'm doubling around back here. And so I know you can't really see this on screen, but if I try to adjust this a little bit, so that you see two little dots there, right? So this is the end of the pipe. I have it covered in blue tape, and this right here is the screw. So, you know, that kind of shows you the perspective of this camera is that, I'm sorry, I'm getting reflections in there. That screw, you know, looks big in the picture, and that pipe end, which is 1.5 inches, looks about the same size, but it's really not. So, you know, on camera, when you're watching this video, this probably just looks like gray smudges. It does look better in person. So in person, it is a little grainy, you know, but I can make out the threads of the screw. I can clearly see in person that that's a screw. So, you know, it works as far as that. It's not a super clear picture, but what we're trying to do here is just identify things that are in a wall or in an engine or lost somewhere. So it does allow you to do that. So I would say that is a success. As far as, actually, let me show you one other thing. This is that button that changes the orientation. So that would put it upside down. That puts it right side up, just to give you an idea. And if I zoom in, here's that button that zooms in, right? That's 1.7, 1.8, 1.9, two times. I have to pull the probe back a little bit or change the orientation. So you can see how that works. All right, here's another quick test for you. This is the arbor screw on my table saw. So you're looking at, this is hard to get on camera. So I needed two hands really to do this. So I got one hand holding the general unit, and I got another hand adjusting the camera, but that's the arbor bolt. And this display is in color, I should mention, but if I look up a little bit, you can see that's the red, saw blade, so you can see that on screen, and that's the arbor screw. So if you're in a very dark place, there's no light in there. I am using the LED light at the end of the probe. And, you know, you can make out plenty of detail there. I don't know if you can see that on what you're watching, but on the camera that I'm watching, you know, I can see plenty of detail there. That would be enough to identify something and, you know, give me some sense of scale. So I'd say that's a success as far as that. All right, I'm trying to get you a little better shot here. The reflection on the screen is from the shop lights, which don't bother me in real life, but the camera picks it up. But anyway, what you're looking at there, I have end of the probe pointed at, there's focus, pointed at the saw blade, okay? So that's where you're looking. And if you look at the screen here, you can see how close it is and what kind of resolution you get. Again, it's not super high resolution by any stretch, but it's enough to identify what you're looking at. And, you know, for the cost of this thing and the fact that it, you know, can take some abuse, I'd say that's pretty decent. So the distance there in real life is about, I don't know, 1.5 inches. And then on screen, that's what you see. I'm trying to get focus there. There's a better focus, all right? All right, here's another perspective. Now, we're in a room with a bunch of light, and it's wide open now. But just to show you what that looks like, I have the camera here pointed basically at my tape measure. And now let me show you a close-up of what the screen looks like. So now, here's a close-up of the screen. You can see the tape measure there. And you can see, you know, some of the rest of the room there. Again, the rest of the room out here, way out there, is going to be out of focus. And the close things are what is going to be in focus. But, you know, even with a lot of light, it's still pretty impressive. Now, as far as using this thing, it really does take two hands to do it right. On the camera itself, there is a little arrow here, which indicates kind of the up, if you will. And even though you can reverse it 180 degrees with this button, you know, you still need to get this oriented, you know, to the upper, so you know which is the top and which is the bottom. using this probe, it's pretty stiff. You sort of need two hands to bend it into place, and it can be awkward, you know, trying to get this oriented just right, and that's why you need two hands. Occasionally the screen does pop out, you know, the video signal pops out, and that's just because it's a little bit loose here, or if you, you know, give it a good yank, it may pop out temporarily, but it comes right back. So as far as using this, it can be a little bit awkward, but that's not the tool's fault. It's just the function of the way it works. Now, do you need one of these things? Well, you know, probably not. They are an interesting tool to have, and in certain circumstances, for example, in construction, you know, if you want to look inside a soffit to see if there's plumbing pipes or, you know, electrical or something in there, yeah, this would be a really handy tool to have. If you're looking inside a wall, you can, you know, pop a little hole for the end of the probe here, look inside a wall and maybe see if there's insulation or not, or see if there's something in the way if you want to cut a wall or open a wall up or whatever. You know, this would be a handy tool to have just to see in advance if there's something in the way. You're not going to, you know, like I said, you're not going to do your own colonoscopies in this. It's not a super high resolution, but for just identifying things that are in a wall, or if you're a mechanic and you're working on cars, you know, identify inside an engine or in a tight space if there's something in the way or something that you've lost. Yeah, this is a really handy tool to have. The cost is not great, and because of that, you're not going to get super high resolution, but you know, for what it is and for what it costs, I'd say it's a pretty decent tool. Whether you need one or not really depends on how much time you're going to spend searching for something, or, you know, wondering about a wall internally before you do something about it. So, you know, that's a decision you'll have to make. But as far as the way it's made, the construction is good. The video out, by the way, is right here. So it's just an 1/8-inch jack. I'm not really sure how useful that is, because you kind of need a video. You need a TV or a monitor or something. It's not going to work with a computer or a laptop, so I'm not really sure how useful that is, but it is there if you need it. So yeah, I think it's a fairly well-made tool. These probe ends where you can pick things up, one is magnetic, one is a mirror, and one is just a hook. Yeah, that could be very useful, I think. If you've lost something, and God knows I spent time over the years, you know, trying to retrieve a lost screw or a bolt or whatever, and something like this could be helpful. So it's a useful tool, I think, in some circumstances. It's not terribly expensive, but whether you need one, you know, that's really up to you as far as how much time you're going to get out of this thing.